So, ladies and gentlemen, we have problems with the camera. Just a moment, and we have a little sound problem. So, I hope this is now okay. So, the issue of our today's summit is again. Ladies and gentlemen, the issue of our today's summit is just for the camera. Yeah, need a little go to the left. Hey, cameraman. So I hope that I can start now and begin with my introduction to our today's issue. Our today's issue is CMS and how to handle it, how to program it, how to set it up. So now let's start. For all the people who never heard about CMS at any time, so this will be new to them, and just open a can of, no, not a can, a bottle of beer, so it's easier for me to speak to this great audience that watching me for talking about content management systems. So cheers. So beer and content system messages, message systems have two things in common. So now let's start with the first one. First one is you have to set it up. This is then you bring it from the fridge and open a can or bottle. That's the same. So load it down from your internet dealer or provider or every place in the internet you have the opportunity to get those things. I'll get a CMS. Then it's commonly SIPT or GZIPT or any packed. So then the open this with a common program. You get it with Windows, you get it with Linux, and all. So let's open it and then put it in your server's root. It may be at home, you can do it per FTP on a remote server. So you need a password and a username to do this. So most of our people want to do it on a remote server, so ask your local provider or the provider you get all the things from, and you get all these names and passwords and such things. So then if you have unpacked it, so and then they have a bunch of PHP scripts, CGIs, and some HTML and includes or something. But that is no problem. If you never heard of PHP or includes or ever, it makes no problem. So then put the whole bunch of PHP things all things you get and put it per versus FTP to your server, and then look for maybe you can start it, or if it's not a real setup or install program, there you have to find another setup or install program, and there is some common things that in all of our CMSs is there. There's, you must know something, and you must know the password, the username of your database. You need the name of the database, and you need your tables, so where you put these things, and then just put it there, put the names if you asked, or if there is a script, if just fill it out and send it up, and all these things then would happen miracles. And I take a little break bottle, though. You can now ask for what is this shit that's meaning. That means nothing. If you are interested in a CMS, just do it. Just work around. Just do things. Just play with it like a girl plays with butterflies, and then you will have learned things to handle. And if not, you just use it as a user and do know much administrator things is then too difficult for you. So if you have done this, then just start index.php. Take your local browser, for instance Internet Explorer, if you got nothing else, then Internet Explorer, go to your home page. For instance, at me is untergang.de, then untergang.de is opened, and you see a setup for your CMS. This screen is very important for the rest of your life, maybe I say for the rest of your life with your CMS. And if you do things wrong, then here, the rest of your life with your CMS is doing so. So look at all the readme texts and fucking manuals and everything, so that you can do it right here. For later on, it's very difficult to change things. So if you're in doubt, you do the right things, then stop it, break it, go to Yahoo or Google or something, Google around and start again. So if you are at the end of this setup, then you have to choose between administrator or front end. Administrator is back end, they call it, so it's very funny. So it's now I roll the cigarette. So now at the back end, now just go to the front end. In the front end, you will see things that you have done, or you don't see things if you've done wrong. And the most of the time, you see things. So then you can change it if you know the password and the username of the administrator. Mostly the name of the administrator is admin or root, and the password is that password you gave during the setup process. So I hope you remember this name. So then go to the admin part, log in, and then you can change everything you want. So if you have done problem there, you want it green or red, or you want it bigger, or you want another picture and in front or in the back, or you have other problems, you cannot solve by clicking around like you are used at your Windows program for XP or so, that you have to know how to PHP or CGI or Perl or Ruby or I don't know all the names. But you, if you have done problems, you cannot click it so as you want, then just be free to call the helpers from www.intergang.de. These people can help you and make everything you want. Bye bye. So I hope this is working now.